سنة تحفظا
The last few weeks have completely destroyed.
I've just told him. Welcome back to Focus here on France 24. Now, for the first time in the history of the world, a country, India, in fact, is accusing a multinational company of biopiracy. That means stealing indigenous plants and then trying to develop genetically modified versions of them without giving any compensation back to the local people or nation where the plants originally came from. Now, the American seed giants Monsanto and its Indian collaborators are being prosecuted for stealing Brinjal to develop genetically modified version called BT Brinjal. Well, a reporter Vikram Singh has been to the area affected and spoken to those who say it's their environment which has been stolen.
Which is essentially owned by Monsanto.
Ground for this environmental activist. Leo Saldana filed the complaint that has led to India charging American agricultural giant Monsanto with biopiracy. And the eggplant, or Brinjal, is what the company is accused of stealing. Leo says Monsanto illegally used indigenous Brinjal varieties to create a genetically modified version of the vegetable.
So there are six varieties taken from Karnataka, which Monsanto has taken without any conformance with the Biological Diversity Act, and therefore it is biopiracy. And once they put the BT gene into Brinjal, then it becomes a commodity which is essentially owned by Monsanto.
The Brinjal is one of the most popular vegetables in India, with close to 2,500 varieties. In 2010, Monsanto's partner companies nearly got approval to commercialize a GM variety called BT Brinjal. But massive public protests forced the government to ban it indefinitely. Undeterred, Monsanto's continued testing other GM crops. 2 months ago, a hastily destroyed experimental field of GM maize was filmed by a local TV crew. Monsanto has been accused by Greenpeace of not informing the field's owner about the nature of the crop.
We didn't really have an agreement. Monsanto just made me sign a form.
What was written on the form?
Nothing. There was just the date and the name of the company.
To find out more, we traveled to Bangalore, home to Monsanto's main research center in India. The company refused requests for interviews and shifted all responsibility to its Indian partner, Mahiko, claiming it had conducted the controversial Brinjal trials. Our camera was clearly not welcome. This is the first time the Indian government has considered pressing charges of biopiracy against a foreign company. Although prosecution could take years, the country's biodiversity protection authorities believe the move is extremely important.
This can send a deterrent message to the big companies for violating the laws of the nation. It is not acceptable to State Biodiversity Board of Karnataka that the farmers and our communities are robbed of the advantage they should get from the indigenous varieties.
India is home to nearly 8% of the planet's living species. A biological treasure chest that's attracting growing attention from companies around the world.
Well, Vikram joins us on the line now from New Delhi. Vikram, first of all, just tell us how far the Indian government's actually got in its efforts to prosecute Monsanto.
Well, Stuart, it's been more than a month since the authorities, in this case the National Biodiversity Authority of India, decided that it was going to take legal action against Monsanto. But so far, no formal charges have been pressed. Now, activists say they're deliberately taking their time because of pressure from pro-GM and pro-Monsanto elements within the authority. But remember, it took them more than a year after the initial complaint filed by the activist that we've seen the report to just get to this stage of deciding to take legal action. We did speak to members of this authority, and they said they needed time to prepare a solid, watertight case because, obviously, this particular affair is very sensitive given the involvement of major multinationals like Monsanto, and they feel that how this case goes will have ramifications beyond just this incident.
So how important would you say actually is this case for India, and is it the kind of thing that's happened before?
Well, in terms of its importance, I'd say it's hugely important because you know, how they handle this will set the precedent for cases in the future. And it is, you know, it's the first time that a company is being accused under the country's Biodiversity Act, which was enacted 10 years ago almost. Now, India has a huge amount of what you could call bio-wealth. It's the fifth richest country in the world in terms of biodiversity. So it is crucial that it protects that and gains from it. In terms of it happening previously, different cases, different sorts of biopiracy have occurred before. India accused, for example, the American company Colgate Palmolive of trying to steal a herbal remedy that was developed here when it tried to patent a turmeric toothpaste. So it has happened before, but not of this particular kind, not biopiracy of this particular kind.
And presumably while filming the report, you had the chance to interact with some of the farmers there. How do they feel about it?
Yeah, we did speak to quite a few farmers across the state of Karnataka, which has become, or at least was, a hotbed for experimentation of various GM crops. Now, a lot of the farmers didn't really have a very concrete idea about the specifics of this case. Remember, it's very technical. But they all seemed very concerned about the arrival of GM crops, saying that it would make them dependent on foreign companies for seeds. And, you know, the few that were using some of Monsanto's hybrid seeds weren't very convinced. We spoke to the vice president of the state's Farmers Association, who said that, you know, referring to this case, said that it was preposterous, in his words, that these varieties that farmers had developed over generations could suddenly be taken away for commercial exploitation by a foreign company, or in this case, Monsanto. So they're very unhappy.
Let's talk about Monsanto themselves then. We saw in your report, obviously, they didn't want to talk to you about it, but it's not their first brush with controversy, is it?
No, it certainly isn't. This is, I guess you could say, it's the latest in a string of controversial incidents for the company in India. Of course, what dominated headlines for a long time here was the company's unsuccessful attempt to introduce genetically modified BT Brinjal to the Indian market. As you see in the report, there's a massive public outcry against that move, and the government had to deny approval to Monsanto in the end. Now, the company has faced problems previously when it tried to introduce BT cotton in India, and BT cotton, it did get permission to introduce that crop, but even since then, there have been accusations that you know, poorer than expected results of BT cotton crops have led to farmer suicides. But it is a huge market for Monsanto, and I think this or any other controversy or problem is unlikely to drive them away.
And finally, Vikram, I mean, the current controversy, of course, much of the bigger part of the larger troubles really being faced by companies trying to introduce GM crops to India, one of the world's biggest agricultural markets. How far away do you think they are, and how likely are they to succeed?
At this stage, I'd say they're rather far away from them, you know, because of the lack of consensus, really, on the issue. Like I said earlier, a lot of farmers and farmer groups are very strongly opposed to the technology, and they do have, you know, considerable political influence. Remember, two-thirds of this country is employed in agriculture. The farmer groups do have a lot of influence. For example, the state of Karnataka, where we filmed, recently declared a ban on GM testing within its boundaries, partially because of pressure from farmers. Some other scientists we spoke to said that they wanted more independent research about the effects of these crops before they were given permission. So companies like Monsanto and others like Cargill and DuPont clearly have their work cut out.
Vikram, thanks a lot. That's Vikram Singh, our correspondent, joining us there from New Delhi. That's today's focus here on France 24. Stay with us.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.